The delay in getting test results, the lack of tests in many states, has of course been a key point of frustration.
But could this new type of test help alleviate some of those issues? Dr. Frank McGeorge is here to explain exactly what is an antigen and how it could help.
This is a step forward in terms of rapid testing. You can get the results in about 15 minutes, and the antigen tests are significantly easier to manufacture, making it more feasible to produce enough to be able to test significantly more people. But the speed and simplicity do come with a trade-off in terms of accuracy.
The FDA issued an emergency use authorization for the new antigen test created by Quidel. The test still uses a swab to collect the sample. So what makes it so different? Well, all of the previous tests for active COVID-19 infections are what we call PCR tests. That means they're looking for genetic material from the coronavirus and multiplying that material until there's enough to detect it. The antigen test is looking for something different. Pieces of surface protein from the virus, usually the spikes, that are big enough to detect without multiplying them. Last month on Meet the Press, Dr. Deborah Birx called for this type of testing breakthrough.
We have to be able to detect antigen rather than constantly trying to detect the actual live virus or the viral particles itself.
There is a downside to antigen tests. They have a higher rate of false negatives. That means if you test positive, you can be confident that's an accurate result. But if you test negative, there's a lower degree of certainty, and your doctor may want to confirm that result with a PCR test, especially if you are showing symptoms.
Remember, there is no perfect test, and that's why we need other measures like masks, social distancing, and hand washing too. Now, this is the first antigen test to be authorized, but it won't be the last. The FDA says it expects antigen tests to play a critical role moving forward. Back to you.